And now the central processing unit, the CPU. The CPU is the brain of a computer and it is responsible for processing the data given by the user. Processing means changing the entered data into meaningful information. This CPU is neither an input nor an output device, but it controls all the input and output device connected to it. All the parts of a computer are connected to the CPU box through wires. As in this picture, you can see that all the wires of the devices are plugged into the CPU cabinet. I have also shown you this in the live classes. Those who have attended the live class, you must be knowing, you must have seen this. So the CPU takes the information given by the input devices, processes it and sends the result to the output device. We have also discussed about the IPO cycle. So this IPO is input, processing and output. Input is given to the computer with the help of input devices. Through the input devices, input is given to the CPU. Processing is done and then the result of processing is displayed through the output devices, is given out through the output devices. This CPU consists of three parts: the control unit, CU, the arithmetic logic unit, ALU, and the memory unit. The control unit controls the working of all the parts of the computer. Arithmetic and logic unit does all the calculations. Any kind of addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, all type of calculations. We have learned, no, that in banks, in shopping malls, bills are generated, calculations, the details of the transaction, everything is recorded on the computer. So the huge addition, huge subtraction, all those calculations become easier when we do it by using a computer. Which part of this is responsible for doing this addition and this subtraction, this calculation? This is the arithmetic and logic unit. And the third part is the memory unit. It stores all the instruction given by the input devices before they are sent for processing. And it also stores the result of output before it is sent to the user. Means it is actually the memory. Everything, all the data and instruction that are need to be processed in the memory unit. The memory unit then passes this data and instruction to the ALU or the CU. And then it is displayed to us. So I hope this part is clear to all of you. Those who have the book, after watching this video, you will read the pages from the book. It will be much easier for you to understand. Now comes the storage devices. Storage devices, by the name you can understand, children, that these are devices used to store data. Storage devices can be internal, it can be external. Storage devices can be primary or secondary. So in your syllabus, we will just learn that there are some devices where we can store data. For example, in the book it is given compact disc, the digital versatile disc and pen drive. These are removable storage devices that can be used to transfer data from one computer to another computer. These are the pictures of CDs and DVDs, and I know all of you are quite familiar with this. This is the drive where you can insert and play the CDs and DVDs. And this is the pen drive. The pen drive is the storage device which is very small in size, but it has the largest storage capacity. It can be easily carried in a pocket or a bag. A pen drive can be used to store and transfer data from one computer to another computer as CDs and DVDs. Okay, the CDs and the DVDs has to be inserted in a disk drive, and this pen drive is inserted into a computer through a USB port. This also I have shown you in the live classes. Those who have missed the live classes, this picture is for them to understand. See, this is the port. The pen drive is inserted inside this type of USB port. In our next live class and in the next video, we will discuss about the software of a computer. Till then, goodbye children. Stay healthy.